chapter 3, that is coordinate geometry. Let us see how to plot a point on our axis. That is, we have seen in number system that how to point a point on the number line system. That is, point means half, 1, 2, 3, 3 by 2, anything. We can point on the number line system. That is, here we can point on 0.5 like that. How to point? We identified that by placing, using a divider, and we are measuring the diagonal angle, and thus we are plotting it on the number line system. In the same manner, we are going to plot. For example, take one example. Suppose you are going to meet your friend who is in Kantinagar colony, and that colony had 5 streets, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, n number of streets, and your friend is in street 1. And you have to know one more important point, that is, in which street she is located and in which street, and also the house number in the particular street. Am I right? Yes. Now your friend is located in street 2, suppose for example, and the house number is number 3. Thus, now when we are traveling from the road, you will be locating first street 2. Then you will be going to the house number 3. And thus you will visit your friend. The two major roads or important points what we should know is the street number and the house number in order to find out the your friend's address. In the same manner, let us take one more example. See, if you have taken one rectangular block and when you place one point, that is 0, or some x point you have placed here. This is x point. Now, in order to find out the position of this point in this block, how you will say? You can say the upper part, or it is very nearer to the left hand part. It is left, right, and this is right, and this is upper or bottom or top, and this is down or bottom. In the same manner, you can say it is upper half, or it is very nearer to the left side, or you can say it is very far to the right side, or you can say it is very nearer to the upper and left corner. In this manner, you will assume that the point has been on this plane. Means you have some assumptions. All the assumptions are true, but you cannot say that exactly the point where it is placed in the plane. That is, in order to find the exact point where it is placed on the plane, we have a great scientist whose name is known as René Descartes. The René Descartes, who is a very popular scientist, has denoted, has given a definition, or he given a solution how to find the exact point of the x on the plane. Means he is given an exact definition how to determine the points on the plane. That is known as Cartesian system. In order to find any point on a plane of xy axis, that is, this is x axis, the horizontal axis is represented as x axis, and the number line system, when it is placed vertically, that is known as y axis. He has defined an exact solution by using these two perpendicular lines, and in order to know this, we can conclude that it is known as Cartesian system. It is known as Cartesian system or coordinate geometry. Same, both are same. That is, in order to locate any point on a geometrical system, it is known as Cartesian geometry or coordinate geometry. In this way, René Descartes, while he was sleeping, he got a solution how to find out. This is a very, very good exact solution we have previously used, and this is based on two perpendicular lines, that is, x-axis and y-axis. Now let us see in detail how to represent each and every term in Cartesian system. Now we know how to represent number line on number system. We have studied in the unit 1, that is in number system. That is, 0 is placed at the center of the number line system, and 0 is known as origin, and up to 0 means the right side of 0 will be known as positive direction. That is, positive numbers, positive integers, or everything that is having the plus sign are denoted on the zeros right side. That is 1, 2, 3 and so on, plus n. And to the left side of the origin, we will be facing the negative direction, that is negative elements minus 2, minus 3 and so on to up to minus n. In the same manner, how we are representing the numbers on the number line system, in the same way, in order to find a point on a system, we have denoted the Cartesian system. In a Cartesian system, we have two perpendicular lines, that is, we will be taking one horizontal line and one vertical line. That is, we have detailedly explained here. Here, see, we are taking one number line system, X. Suppose it is named as X. It is known as horizontal number line system. Here, 0 is the origin and this is positive direction, this is negative direction. And if we place this number line system in vertical manner, that is here, it is known as vertical number line system. And let us denote it as Y. Now, 0 is the origin and positive direction and negative direction. These two lines will always be perpendicular. According to René Descartes, the great scientist, he has proved any two lines will always be intersected in perpendicular manner. That is, see, suppose if two lines are intersected in such a manner, then these are in perpendicular to each other. Either in diagonal manner also it is known as they are in perpendicular to each other. So, by this just one idea, he had designed the Cartesian system. Now, let us see how the coordinate plane is defined and what are the terms included in the coordinate plane. That is, previously I have said when two perpendicular lines, when met at a point, they form an origin, and these two perpendicular lines represents the coordinate plane, that is, the x horizontal plane having two directions, that is positive direction and negative direction. The x represents the positive direction and x dash represents the negative direction. At the same time, the vertical line or number line vertically represented is known as y-axis. It also has one origin point and one positive direction and one negative direction. The positive direction is represented by y and the negative direction is represented by y dash. At the same time, when it is divided, we will be obtaining four parts. They are known as quadrants. The each space is known as quadrant space. And this XY having both positive values is known as first quadrant. And the X having the negative value and Y having the positive value is known as second quadrant. And having the X and Y both having negative values is known as third quadrant. And having Y negative values and X with positive values is known as fourth quadrant. Each and every quadrant have we can resemble any point on these four quadrants. That's why this is very known as coordinate plane. And next one, let us see that 0 to 1 is known as 1 centimeter. We will be defining in such a way exactly it measures 1 centimeter. And next, the important point is the X coordinate is also known as the representation of horizontal line is known as X coordinate, and X coordinate is also known as abscissa. It's a very important bit. X coordinate is also known as abscissa, and the Y coordinate is also known as ordinate. Y coordinate is also known as ordinate. It is represented in vertical form. In the same manner, let us take one point P equals to 2 comma 3. Let us represent it on the coordinate plane. It is having both positive values 2 and 3. So plus 2, here we will be representing in a bracket. We will first denote the first element as x value and the next element as the y value. So in this, we will be representing the horizontal distance from the origin is, that is plus 2 centimeters is known as plus 2. Means the distance which is measured parallelly in a horizontal way is known as x-axis point, and which is measured in vertical way which is parallel to y-axis is known as y-point. That is, we can say in another way, that is, let us take one point P, that is 2, 3. PF represents the length or measurement in vertical form, that is plus 3, and PN is plus 2. This is positive direction and this is negative direction. And also one more important one is that we have to measure the angles. The total four quadrants equals to 360 degrees, and the first quadrant consists of 0 to 90 degrees, that is, forms a 90 degrees, that any value or any angle theta, we which lies in first quadrant is 0 is less than theta is less than 90 degrees, and in second quadrant the theta lies between 90 degrees and 180 degrees, and in the third quadrant the theta lies between 180 degrees and 270 degrees, and in fourth quadrant the theta lies between 270 degrees and 360 degrees. The whole quadrants will form equals to 360 degrees. The sum of the degrees equals to 360 degrees.